every time I'd been wrong, I'd be a self-made.
Family vacations. A lot of fun. Of course, when I say a lot of fun, I'm being absolutely sarcastic, but, you know, we gotta pretend, don't we? Our latest endeavor took us high into the Catskill Mountains, to the Raleigh Resort Hotel. According to my grandmother, the Raleigh was a hopping place during the 1960s and 70s, and entertained the likes of the rich and famous. But upon getting closer to our destination, I made the realization that this area of the world had never left the 70s and seemed to be in a state of perpetual time warp. Not only that, but it was in a mostly Hasidic Jew-dominated area, which foreshadowed the type of people we would be there with and the limited number of food we would be having. The once roaring place that my grandmother spoke of was more like a senior citizen rest home than a resort hotel. Boy, it was gonna be a long weekend. Like any normal family, after unpacking our things, we headed straight for the pool.
It's like the friggin' Haunted Mansion in here, I swear to God.
What?
It's like the Haunted Mansion in this place.
You know how old this place is?
It's the Haunted Mansion.
Shh, the old people don't like it when you say that.
Obviously.
Disturb them.
You can check in, but you can't check out.
Jeffrey, you tolerate it for 2 minutes. What'd you say, you check in, but you don't check out?
Yeah.
That's not nice.
So any floating candles down there?
I hear noises. What kind of special effects you have on there?
I'll show you in a second. Hang on. There's a whole bunch of them.
Ah yes, the pool. There is nothing quite like watching geriatric people have near-death experiences because they are afraid of the water. But aside from that, there is so much fun to be seen at the pool. For example, this woman. I don't know whether she's got a fungus on her head, or if she's some mutated plant experiment gone horribly wrong. And from the look on my cousin Jason's face, you just know he accidentally peed in the pool. Uh-oh, looks like he's not the only one. Let's take a look at the pool rules. It says no running, no jumping, no diving, and no horseplay. But if you look carefully, I'm pretty sure it says no pool rules also. Pretty tricky. I bet you right now that these people are wishing that they could swim. The pool is run by this man. Just by looking at him, you can tell he keeps his body in shape just in case he needs to jump in and make a daring rescue. Notice his Austin Powers-like chest hair.
Good, baby! Very good!
Hopefully, this allows him to swim faster in the face of danger. Upon staring at this man some more, I'm pretty sure I know his distant cousin. Here, take a look at these two photos and compare. Pretty weird, huh? With my family still at the pool, I decided to take a look around. Outside, the hotel/rest home is deceiving to the human eye and looks like any other resort. You know from what I have told you thus far that it is not. I was amazed that the patients were allowed to wander the grounds without supervision. Oh wait, did I say patients? I meant to say guests. Funny how these two are confused in this place. Inside was just as much fun as out. Notice the party in the bridge room. If that's too wild and crazy for you, make sure to check out the intense bingo games. Must have been too much excitement for this young lady. Nighty night. After walking around a bit and getting to the JFK wing, I made another realization.
I really think we came here to die.
With that cheerful thought in my head, I wandered around some more and arrived at D floor. Apparently, it was D floor to be on. Get it? D floor? Right. Anyway, it was on this floor that I found this little goldmine of hilarity. Someone wrote on a piece of paper, "Don't disturb me," and left it outside their room, on the floor, so no one would bother them. That's right, folks, disturb. That's D-E-S-T-U-R-B. I guess a dictionary wasn't handy or anything. After nearly dying of laughter from people's stupidity, I wandered again. I found that right behind the bar area was some sort of group therapy session. Not wanting to interrupt, I moved on again, this time with my mom and Aunt Solange. We walked to the hallway leading to the nightclub, which I'm sure most guests don't get to see because they have already been sleeping for 5 hours before it even opens. There, I noticed one of the windows had a bullet hole in it. Looked to me like someone tried to escape. And of course, what would any rest home be without a thrift store? Yes, the sign outside does say beauty salon and boutique, but seriously, can you see the stuff they have there? I would be caught dead wearing any of it, which I'm sure the clothes' last owners were. By this time, dinner was being prepared, so we headed for the dining room. Judging from the number of people already there, it seemed as if people had been lining up for hours eating. When the doors to the dining hall were finally open, one can notice how the rushing of the crowd into the room closely resembled Moses parting the Red Sea. And I can't understand what all the hurrying was about. The food was kosher. When we did finally get past the swarm of elderly trying to get to their early bird specials, we found our seats and sat down. Now would probably be a good time to introduce my family and why we're here to begin with. These two here are my cousins, Josh and Jason. Next to them are their parents, Uncle Stephen and Aunt Jen. That's my Aunt Solange, Uncle Michael, and their daughter Dominique. Those two right there are my parents, Richard and Michelle. That right there is my little brother, Justin. And finally, my grandparents, Chuck and Phyllis. Now, as for the reason we're all here, we're celebrating my grandfather's 70th birthday. Now, why you would want to spend your birthday in a rest home is beyond me, but, you know, at least the whole family's all here. When we did finally get settled in, our waiter came over and introduced himself. His name was Emilio.
I was like, Emilio! The Mighty Duckman, I swear to God, I was there!
I had to fight the urge to say that. Anyway, Emilio's partner was a busboy named Jeff, who reminded me of Lurch from the Addams Family. As a matter of fact, many people in this place reminded me of someone else. For example, this waiter here. Can you say, Mr. Miyagi?
Wax on, wax off.
And I kept humming a certain tune whenever I saw this guy walk around. Not that I should really say anything about what the waiters look like, because my Uncle Michael does remind me a bit of a certain candy maker. Decide for yourself.
Impossible, my dear lady. That's absurd. Unthinkable.
Anyway, back on subject. The food was to be served. Now, it being kosher, I was a bit scared of how it would taste. I mean, look, they had matzo balls already on the table when we got there, so they just assumed that we wanted them. When the food did get around to arriving, everyone was served. Except for me. Look, food? No food. Food, 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 food. No food. Eventually my pasta did come. Pretty appetizing looking, huh? After having an ever so good meal, one thinks about how much to tip the waiter. Luckily for each person, the hotel strategically placed Sir Walter's Guide on Tipping on every table, so we didn't even have to figure out the math. During the meal, I happened to notice this colorful character sitting at the table next to us. I knew he just had to be an entertainer. Well, for his sake, I hoped he was. Anyway, I couldn't figure out if he was gay or not. Luckily, before the night was over, my suspicions were confirmed, and he came out of the closet for everyone.
When he saw Nicky the announcement, didn't you think you were at Kellerman's Dirty Dancing?
After dinner, we headed off to the arcade. You can tell that the Riley Hotel stays up with the gaming scene, with such recent hits as WWF WrestleFest and Ms. Pac-Man. Now outside with the family, we went to go see the other gaming areas. I'm guessing the outdoor ping pong gets pretty intense because the nets were made of metal. Next to them were the shuffleboard courts. Here, my Uncle Michael is teaching Justin some of the finer points of the game. But then, a sudden flash of the light caught my eyes. I couldn't figure out what was going on. Until I saw that my grandfather was trying to escape. I guess you can't leave that easily. Back inside the safety of the hotel, we decided to sit in the lobby for a bit. This gentleman here was reciting poetry he wrote to some of the guests. Even my grandfather was getting into it. Do you know when you get a new shirt, sometimes there's a sticker on the front telling you how big it is? And before you wear it, you're supposed to take the sticker off? Well, apparently this guy's never heard of that before. Or maybe he just thinks he's stylish. On the other side of the lobby was a clothing sale, where everything someone died in was half off. Pretty good deals. Getting away from the excitement, we went to the indoor mini golf course. I guess they couldn't make it too challenging for the guests, otherwise they might have a heart attack from frustration. By this time, we had all had enough, and it was time for bed. So we decided to head back up to the room.
We'll put all the old fuzzies to sleep. And the young people are going to go down and watch.
Here's a comedian playing the Bosch belt.
Yeah.
E.
E, just.
E, the letter E for Uston.
Up! Easton.
No. All for E? No, up is U. Sounds like
up a U.
Sounds like a U. Here.
Should be very quiet because people are sleeping
here. People are sleeping since 4 o'clock. What are you talking about? No, there's no secret. 3:30. Sorry.
The yield is right. And I thought Buddy Hackett was going to be here.
We have another very good comedian who wanted to salvage. It's so good.
I like the painted mezuzahs.
Tell me, you forgot your
get your meat. Yeah, but he needs some.
Cannolis. Let's go.
Of course, before I went to sleep, I just had to break something. It wasn't even on purpose.
He's broken.
There's a string.
Yeah, on the other side.
You just broke the tray.
Your mom's kitty.
In the corner there.
What are you talking about? Why would they put it all the way?
No, I'm fine. Sure.
Let's have
yeah.
a cannoli.
I ate half.
How do you like them?
All right, so I broke it.
You
broke it. Don't wake us up when the sun comes through in your room.
Yeah, really.
Morning. There's nothing quite like starting off your day with a complaint to the front desk, which my grandfather is shown doing here. But after that incident, it was off to an uneventful breakfast, which really isn't worth mentioning. Before I went to do anything that day, I had to look around the room for anything strange. In the bathroom, I happened to notice a towel wedged into the ceiling. Its purpose, I still don't know. Along the same lines, each drawer had a lining of white paper. Yet again, useless in my eyes, but necessary in the resorts. After that, we decided what to do for the day. Here, my grandmother reminisces about her childhood.
To South Fallsburg, here I can find the road that would lead me to my first bungalow colony when I was here when I was 5 years old.
True.
I bet you I found it.
With that out of the way, we went to our second complaint of the day.
My son had food under his bed.
Is that the one that he brought the crackers down the other day this morning?
They still didn't clean it?
She cleaned it.
Oh,
my daughter's bathroom is still filthy.
It's like, cool.
I know.
Hair all over the floor.
Really?
It's amazing.
This is A48 and 50?
50, and my son's room, I think, is 51.
Yeah.
All four.
Now, I don't know if you noticed this before, but check out the angry woman behind my grandmother. Man, if looks could kill, I'd be as dead as most of the guests in this place. Before going any further with our day, I guess my dad started to accept the fact that he one day might be in one of these places, so we might as well start practicing for it now. During the daylight hours, guests can leave the resort, so me, my dad, and my mom, and Justin went into town to look around. Well, if you can't tell, there isn't much to look at. Everything there was either going out of business, or not really a place you'd want to walk into. And what would any family vacation be without a trip to Walmart? Not just any Walmart, but a Walmart Supercenter. Due to store regulations, I wasn't able to bring my camera inside, but trust me, nobody in the world needs a Walmart that big. After coming home from there, we found out that the others went to the pool. Unfortunately, I wasn't there to get my grandfather jumping in with his wallet, but I did get him trying to dry out his money with a hairdryer.
Mm-hmm.
Have you heard of hot money? Now you see wet money.
Oh man.
Oh, we got $3 that are dry now.
Jesus.
What's the matter? Yeah. Feel it.
Well, just let it go, it'll dry by itself.
Feel it.
Lunch was next. Yet again, nothing too exciting, but Dominique did get to show us her impression of a dog. Remember this angry woman? How can you forget a face like that? Anyway, well, here she is again. Apparently, she's the one who wrote the movie Dirty Dancing and gave a little speech about it after lunch for the guests who cared. Guess what? No one did. Anyway,
Her husband was a so-called famous comedian who based his entire routine around the game Simon Says. Well, if he's performing at the Raleigh, he can't be all that famous. But my dad, my grandmother, and Justin all got into the game. The guy tried to get my Uncle Steven in, but that didn't work as well as he planned it to, so he thought it would be funny to keep mentioning that. I really don't think these clips need an explanation, so just watch.
Hold it, you gotta pass your test. Simon says, step back. Simon says, you are blank?
Yes.
Are you related to that guy over there? I am. Who is he? Your uncle. Look, get in and I'll push out first to get even with you. Who do you like more, me or your uncle?
All right, Josh.
I have a problem. I fall out. And if I get it, put them all out, I end up playing with myself. Time to sit down.
I'm good. No, you get it. I'm good. No, you
get it. Out. Come on. Simon says, say to him, I'm better than you and my uncle. So how are you doing, babe? Good, a little out.
Terrific.
You're out. You want a chance? Simon says, you want a chance? Well, give me that signal.
Sure. That's me.
Simon says, answer him.
I'm not afraid of you.
Simon says, answer each other. Simon says,
you're not afraid of me?
Simon says, answer him.
I'm not afraid of you.
Well, right now, dinner isn't quite ready yet, so here's a random montage of people dancing to tide you over for a few seconds.
Put the fucking mic on. Mic is on. Joe cracked the dawn,
Yes, that was useless, but come on, you laughed. It was funny. Yeah, that's what I thought. Well, dinner is finally ready now, and yet again, the entire family is here for a wonderful meal. But this time, they get a birthday cake.
Birthday, Chuck and Jason. Happy birthday to you.
That's me.
Blow that sparkle out. Come on.
Not even with their combined powers can my grandfather and Jason blow out the candles. Luckily, Josh was there to lend a hand.
Come on, Jay.
And of course, when the dessert is served, we all have to eat. When we're all done stuffing our faces, my grandfather made a nice little speech.
Now, when you're ready,
all right, go ahead.
On behalf of Jason and myself, we want to thank you for coming to our birthday party and making it very memorable. Right?
Thank you.
Thank you.
The highlight of the meal, though, was for the second time that weekend, this man came out of the closet again. While walking out of dinner, I saw this oddly shaped lump lying on the table. I just knew someone wasn't going to make it through the weekend. I guess it was this guy. After that, my Uncle Michael decided to go to the arcade again. There, he rocked the house with his Pac-Man playing skills and defeated anyone he played against. Some may call that too much free time, but he likes to call it skill. If you notice, there was a girl standing next to my uncle. Her name was Jen. Wanting to get away from my family for a while, I hung out with her and her sister Liz. For the next hour and a half, we wandered around the hotel grounds. Apparently, they heard rumors of a beast man wandering the area and wanted to check it out. Unfortunately for them, I had already seen the beast man in his natural habitat. And so ends another day at the Raleigh Resort, and I went back to my room for another night of slumber. Thank God. Finally, it's our last day here. We woke up early to go to breakfast and get it over with. Yet again, not much happened, except that I saw Richard Simmons' older brother. Outside of the dining hall, I was surprised to see an older Dr. Lecter sitting on the bench.
Is this Clarice? Ah, hello, Clarice.
Back upstairs in the rooms, we all started to pack and got ready to leave before the senior citizens wouldn't let us.
Just for nothing.
Well, there's
still other people. Well, true. Not surprisingly, I noticed this young lady still hadn't left her spot the entire weekend. A certain phrase ran through my head when I was thinking of her.
I've fallen, and I can't get up!
We decided to go out a side entrance so the other people wouldn't see us leaving and try to make us stay. And trust me, staying was the last thing I wanted to do. After packing up our cars, it was time to say our goodbyes.
Thank you. Yeah, have a good trip home.
Thank you. Safe trip.
Speak to you later, okay?
Bye.
Thank you, Jeffrey. Bye, you were wonderful. I really appreciate it.
And so ended our weekend in the world of geriatrics. I noticed that once we started to leave the air smelled a bit cleaner and the world seemed a bit brighter. I don't think I'll ever again misappreciate the world I live in, because one day I just might wound up in a place like this. Damn it, Justin, can't you see him in the middle of something?
I gotta tell you something.
What?
Mom said don't make any plans for the next weekend.
Why?
Because it's Nana's birthday and she brought us up to the Poconos for another fun family vacation.
Known as the bumbling fools, watching the game, and the best things in life is the motto and the rule. But if you can open up your heart and hear me out just for tonight, maybe I got something to prove to you. I gotta show you I can do it right. Get out, don't want to see you again. Maybe we can still be friends. Cause I'm your average.